The first meeting of the Karnataka Groundwater Authority was held on 5th May 2012. But without the nominations of two experts and four representatives, for the very reason we could not able to announce the area, notify the area for control and development of groundwater, development and management in the state. Now that those bodies also have been nominated by the government, very soon we will be able to have another meeting, and probably we will be the first next task is to declare the area for control and development of regulation. That is based on our recent groundwater estimation that we have made in the state as to 30th March 2009, which was published in 2010. As per that, the overexploited blocks defined, probably we will be able to put to all those blocks, watershed wise, we have made it. But that will happen only by 4 months now. Only after declaration of the area, the other process starts. But right now, as part of the Groundwater Act in the state, as we have seen, as per the model bill of Government of India 1996 and 2005, the act has been enacted in the other states also. But unfortunately, even including Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, they could not able to implement the act as per the regulations. The reasons are many. Maybe the political will or the awareness is not gone to the public to the required level. And probably we are also hoping like that. But on the safer side, now we are defining the Groundwater Act is essentially with us as an enabling act rather than enforcing act. With the minimum staff we have with us, we will not be able to certainly achieve 100% result with that. But once the area is declared, the process starts with the drilling registration, drilling agencies, registration of drilling agencies in the state. Where henceforth, in the declared notified area, they have to obtain the permission of the authority before proceeding for drilling. So also, in the notified area, all the existing users will have to take the, they have to register them first with the authority, and their registration may be accepted or may be rejected also with the authority, depending upon the other process mentioned in the rules. For any drilling, further drilling also in the notified area, the applicant or the person who wants to have a fresh borewell, they also have to take a permission of the authority. Thereby, if they do not follow it, there's a penalty clause in the act, both penalty by rupees or in the imprisonment also. That will be added with the oath for the violation of the act. And more than which, one more very important thing is, earlier so far we have the spacing criteria between the wells. That we have removed from this act here. For the reason, just if anybody drills adjacent to that, saying that I'm paying the penalty and I will use it water in that. Instead, we thought of the authority should inspect the area. If it satisfies that any more additional borewell can be given there, it gives, depending upon the resource availability, which is a dynamic factor. Today, at the time of declaration, it may be like that, but the situation improves with the more awareness and the utilization level and other things. Authority, if it's, it will give the permission for drilling of borewells, even adjacent to the area, depending upon the geological structures and the scientific information that we are collecting and obtaining from the district level and other places. And second thing is, for the domestic and irrigation waters, the agricultural purpose, the user fee we are not may fix anything there. But for the commercial and industrial and entertainment, so we want to fix up the meters now, water meters. Once the area is declared, they will have 3 months time to register with the authority. Then onwards, strictly they have to go obey the metering. And as per the resource usage there, they have to pay the meter charges to the government. Our idea now is then, we will be collecting the information about the discharge of the water from that resources or borewell point sources. Then if it is susceptible for that to continue, we are going to continue. Otherwise, we stop it there. Other than fixing the 250 meter interval, the spacing, we would like to put on the source discharge itself. This is one of the correlative discharge. Very interesting. And your authority for the second meeting will be in June, July. It will be declaring the area. Once that area is notified, all this process starts there. And in Karnataka, we have other two acts. Other than this, sir, I asked the morning, what about this water quality issues? And what are issues in the cities? We are not sure of this. We have other rules. Karnataka Groundwater Drinking Water Protection Rule 1999, enacted in the year 2003. That very clearly gives all the powers to control and regulate even the drinking water sources by the urban area as well as in the rural areas with the respective authority, appropriate authority itself. Then the Deputy Commissioner, the over district is there, the chairman for that. And in Bangalore, BWSSP has appointed or nominated as an administrative chief as appropriate authority there. Through that they could have done it, but unfortunately it was not done. Till last week we had a meeting with the Minister, BWSSP and the MD also. And when they have asked us to control the present day problem in Bangalore under the Groundwater Authority Act, we have shown that the act which is already there in 2003. Then the Minister said this was not known to us and we were acting on that itself. And with the act here, since the Karnataka Groundwater Act is applicable to the whole of the state, we are certainly there to protect this also. Even the Bangalore Urban Water Supplies controlling also will be there under regulation, along with the BWSSP. But now, under the Act, we would like to have all the district level, the Deputy Commissioner, is the committee for that. Deputy Commissioner of the district is the chairman of the district level. And for the Bangalore, we would like to have the BWSSP chief engineer as a controlling authority for that. Through this, this is an idea we just know right now. And I think I welcome any suggestion, because in the next meeting also be there, we can put forward, we'll see that it comes to the effect. That will be helpful for us also to implement those things. Thank you.